Assalamu alaikum. As you probably knew, there was a period in history which existed between 750 CE to 1258 CE, known as the Islamic Golden Age. During this period, huge advancements and innovations were made in numerous fields. One of the most notable fields was the field of medicine and healthcare. Now, we're going to discuss, if not all, some of the major highlights in medicine during this period that shaped the modern world we all live today. As a hint, we are going to talk about the great Ibn Sina, Ar-Razi, and some of the great scholars during this period. So, let's begin. Among the important figures in Islamic Golden Age, there was Ar-Razi, or Abu Bakr Muhammad ibn Zakaria Al-Razi, known in Latin as Rhazes. Was born in 854 CE in Ray, Persia, was a Persian pharmacologist, alchemist, philosopher, and physician who ran the hospital in Baghdad. He was also known as the father of medicine for his contributions in medicine. Well, all of you know what is the two diseases measles and smallpox are, right? Right? Because back then it was only known as rashes. Al-Razi was the first one to differentiate through careful observation the two diseases smallpox and measles, which were previously lumped together as a single disease called rashes. As Al-Razi based this on the location and time of the appearance of the symptoms, and he also scaled the degree of severity and prognosis of infections according to the color and location of rashes. He was also known as the first one to introduce the concept of control experiments, which is used in many fields today. In hospitals, this method is used with babies to test new medicines like magnesium sulfate. That is, to give a number of babies with a medicine and some babies without as a control group. Without this method, most medical experiments today could not be done. Although Ar-Razi was suffering from a serious eye disease known as glaucoma, that did not stop him from doing his work. Ar-Razi was the greatest medical scholar and practitioner of his day. He wrote more than 200 manuscripts in his life and also wrote medical texts that were used hundreds of years later in the Middle East. His work was mostly based on Hippocratic medicine and Galen. During this time, sickness was claimed as a punishment from God. However, Ar-Razi encouraged doctors to read the latest medical text to update themselves about treatment. This is in line with the hadith of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam: make use of medical treatment, for God has not made a disease without appointing a remedy for it, with the exception of one disease, namely old age. He also wrote the comprehensive book of medicine, which consisted of all available treatment during his time. He also wrote the first medical manual for home use, titled A Medical Advisor for the General Public, which included remedies for simple colds to indigestion.
In today's world, heart diseases have become a major problem. However, there are treatments for these diseases. This is mainly because of the understanding of the human heart. Nevertheless, such advancement and understanding of the heart would not have been possible without the contribution of one scholar named Ibn al-Nafis.
Who is Ibn al-Nafis? Ala al-Din Abu al-Ala Ali Ibn Abi Hazmi al-Qurashi, better known as Ibn al-Nafis, was born in the year of 1213 AD in Damascus. He was educated at the Medical College Hospital Bimaristan al-Nuri, founded by Nur al-Din al-Zanki. Apart from medicine, Ibn al-Nafis learned jurisprudence, literature, and theology. He thus became a renowned expert on the Shafi'i school of jurisprudence, as well as a reputed physician. In the year of 1236, Ibn al-Nafis moved to Egypt and worked in Al-Nasri Hospital, then in Al-Mansuri Hospital, where he became chief of physicians and sultanate personal physicians. The most voluminous of his books is Al-Shamil fi al-Tibb, which was designed to be encyclopedia comprising 300 volumes but was not completed as a result of his death. The manuscript is available in Damascus. His book on ophthalmology is largely an original contribution and is also extant. His book that became most famous, however, was Mujaz al-Qanun, The Summary of Law, and a number of commentaries that were written on the same topic. His commentaries include one on Hippocrates' book and several volumes on Ibn Sina's Qanun, which are still extant. His major original contribution of great significance was his discovery of the pulmonary circulation, which was discovered by modern science after a lapse of 3 centuries. He was the first to correctly describe the constitution of the lungs and gave a description of the bronchi and the interaction between the human body's vessel for air and blood. He also elaborated on the function of the coronary arteries as suppliers of blood to the cardiac musculature. It was commonly believed that the discovery of pulmonary circulation, that is, the movement of blood from the right to the left ventricles of the heart via the lungs, had its inception in Europe in the 16th century by Sir Vitus, Vesalius, Colombo, and finally Harvey.
All operations in hospitals are done by doing major surgeries. Without the field of surgery, major diseases like tumor or the need for heart transplant could not be done. And the field of surgery is reaching new heights every single day. Nevertheless, without the input of this great scholar named Al-Zahrawi, surgery would not be as advanced as we know it today. Al-Zahrawi, or Abu al-Qasim Khalaf ibn al-Abbas al-Zahrawi al-Ansari, known as Abu Qasis in Latin, was a brilliant surgeon born in Medina Azahara, al-Andalus, in 936 CE. He is also sometimes known as the father of surgery for his contributions in the field of surgery. Al-Zahrawi compiled a 30-volume encyclopedia named Al-Tazrif, The Method of Medicine, which includes his experiences in treating the sick, surgical instruments, operating techniques, pharmacological methods to prepare tablets and drugs to protect the heart, surgical procedures used in midwifery, and many more. Al-Zahrawi invented over 200 surgical instruments, many of which are still in use today. This includes forceps, scalpel, surgical needle and retractor, specula and catgut sutures. He was also the first physician to describe an ectopic pregnancy and the first to identify the hereditary nature of hemophilia. That's interesting. Anyway, finally, let's move on to the next greatest scholar. He's one of the legendary and greatest scholars ever known in the Islamic Golden Age. He's also known as the father of modern medicine, and his name is Ibn Sina.
Ibn Sina, or some might know him better by his Latinized name, Avicenna. Ibn Sina was a 10th century philosopher and physician who lived in Hamadan and Jordan from the year of 980 to 1037 CE, and acquired great fame in medieval European medicine. He was born in Uzbekistan on the 22nd of August 980 AD, and he will die on June 21st in the year of 1037 in Iran. Arguably, the most important work during the Golden Age was a book called The Canon of Medicine. It presents an overview of the contemporary medical knowledge of the medieval Islamic world, which had been influenced by earlier traditions including Greco-Roman medicine, particularly Galen, Persian medicine and Indian medicine. The canon of medicine remained a medical authority for centuries. It set the standards for medicine in medieval Europe and the Islamic world, and was used as a standard medical textbook through the 18th century in Europe. It is still used in United medicine, a form of traditional medicine practiced in India. In the essence of the canon of medicine is an encyclopedia of medicine, still being used today because of its simplicity and diversity of medicinal and health-related knowledge. He even expanded on many of these ideas. This book, containing of 5 volumes, was finished in the year of 1025. The Book of Canon of Medicine is divided into 5 books. The first book, Essays on Basic Medical and Physiological Principle, Anatomy, Regimen, and General Therapeutic Procedures. Second book, List of Medical Substances, arranged alphabetically following an essay on their general properties. The third book, Diagnosis and Treatment of Disease Specific to One Part of the Body. The fourth book, Diagnosis and Treatment of Conditions Covering Multiple Body Parts or the Entire Body. And the last one, Formulary of Compound Remedies. In fact, William Osler, a famous Canadian physician, a key figure in modern medicine, once called the Canon of Medicine as the most famous medical textbook ever written, by noting that the book has remained a medical bible for longer time than any other work.
One thing to note and learn from these great contributions from these scholars is about medieval Islam's openness to ideas that help make advances, especially in the field of medicine. This can be seen as back then, people used to go to Baghdad, which was known as the center of knowledge, just to learn about the new techniques and the latest innovations in science. I shall end with a statement from Ibn Rushd. Whoever becomes fully aware of the wonders of human anatomy and physiology will find his faith in God increases. That's all, signing off.